gave me such an important part in this time. Go to my people Israel and say to them to build my temple.
Oh, but all of these difficulties. Okay, but it's still possible.
To build a temple on the Temple Mount is much easier than to establish the state of Israel. But first, they started developing the simple vessels, the vessels needed for the incense and the offerings.
We did something like 7-8 items for the temple. We have a list of 99 items to do. And we will now start to be in a hurry to succeed to do all the items before the temple will build.
At the same time, they were creating the musical instruments, the harp, the lyre, then the vestments. And this menorah is a $3 million menorah. It's made of 42 kilos of pure 24 karat gold. And now, the latest project is we have there's a team of architects who are working on the blueprint.
For me, we start now to feel like the Masech is coming, or not, the time of the temple is coming.
And the time is short. I think it's somewhere between now and 10 years or something like that.
It's already ready. We're ready for it.
The temple can be built only in one place. A place chosen by God.
Only in the place that God chose thousands of years ago to be his temple.
The location chosen by God.
On the same lines.
God chose a location.
Of the first and the second temple. The
location that God chose is the mountain of Moriah.
And the holy temple has to be planted on the holy temple in Jerusalem.
The location chosen by God is the place today where the temple, where the Mount of Rock is. On the Temple Mount.
Issue is not acceptable by many, many Muslims or many, many Palestinians or many, many Arabs. The Dome of the Rock to the Muslim, it's a very, very holy shrine, very holy place. They think from there where Muhammad ascended to heaven.
I believe that the temple will be rebuilt again.
That the temple is going to be built on the Temple Mount.
It's
circumstances become right, they can accomplish it. If they decide to do it, and if the circumstances were to become right, then they can do it. I mean,
says that there are
horrible disasters
would lead to a kind of what they call intifada or revolt or maybe war and so on.
In the Arab world, in all the Muslim countries, in Pakistan, in Indonesia, in Afghanistan, in Egypt, in Syria, there will be a big movement. Maybe the Islamic Organization Conference, which have 70 countries, might do something.
With the cost of an awful lot of Israeli and Arab lives, too, that are lost in the war. It will be, something like 5/6 of the army that comes up against Jerusalem will perish. But that's what will happen at that time. It'll take just months and months to bury the dead. The big battle at the end of the tribulation is the battle at Armageddon.
During the last days, during the tribulation, actually before the Lord comes, there will be a change.
I think the building of the temple signals things are coming to an end very, very quickly. And the preparations for it in Israel now are another sign that these things are coming very quickly. How quickly, I don't know. But ours could be the generation in which Jesus came back again.